This year, while most people trick-or-treated in their own neighborhoods during Halloween, one organization decided to take a different approach to this popular tradition. Members of Sevier Heights Baptist Church organized what they called community harvest parties. 8 parties took place across Knoxville in areas such as the Lonsdale community, Blount County, and Island Home Park. Each festival was unique, but most involved free food, games, and of course, candy. One such harvest festival took place in the West Knoxville neighborhood Gallagher Station. Neighborhood residents Matt and Monica Sellers have been hosting the party on their front lawn since before the church even began promoting the festivals.
We started it probably 6 to 8 years ago. So we wanted to do something for the kids, and so we started making hot dogs and giving them out to the kids, and then we invited our church to be a part of it, and so we started giving out tracts. Then it's grown and grown from that until this year, where we have 35, 40 people here helping put it on. We have invited the entire West Hills Elementary School, which is 873 kids. We invited all the neighborhoods with flyers, so we've invited over 1,200 kids.
The event involved cornhole games, hot dogs, s'mores, and a raffle for an iPod shuffle. The festival concluded with a costume parade around the neighborhood. Several hundred people participated, sporting a variety of unique outfits. Even some pets dressed up for the occasion. Festivals took place at other venues around Knoxville as well. Island Home Park hosted one of the largest of these harvest parties. Although hundreds of people around the Island Home community came to the festival, this event catered particularly to the Tennessee School for the Deaf. Over 30 deaf students attended the festival. Sevier Heights member Laura Buckner was excited about the activities the festival included.
They had like a little inflatable for the little kids, and they're giving away a $25 Walmart gift card, and they have free Taco Bell, free candy, free popcorn.
Members of the church karate team also performed. UT journalism student Amy Boshears commented about the demonstration.
There's a martial arts show going on behind me, breaking boards, breaking faces, safely and having a good time.
Other activities included face painting, basketball, and a dance competition between students from the Tennessee School of the Deaf and members of the UT football team. Many other UT athletes attended the event as well. UT theater professor Tracy Copeland Halter was largely responsible for the high athletic involvement.
There were tons of student athletes here, some of them who, most of them currently in my class right now, my Theater 100 class at UT, and some of them in classes before. I just have built really good relationships with a lot of the student athletes, and they came to help out and do the community a service, and so they've been excellent, and the kids have loved it.
The athletes included, among others, Matt Milton, Derek Rogers, Brent Brewer, and Matt Wegson, as well as members of the UT women's track team, such as Kiana Ruff. The Lady Vols soccer team also signed autographs at the event. Soccer player Grace Cunin related her own story of involvement in the deaf community.
I'm an interpreting major, so I really liked it. It was a good opportunity for me to practice and just to get out and talk to kids in the deaf community, for sure. I started that major my freshman year, and I'm a senior now, so I'm actually about to do, I'll do my internship this summer.
The parties lasted until around 9:30 p.m., More than 5,000 people attended the festivals, in addition to those who helped organize and staff the events.